Chris, you don't have any damn shoes on.
I'm sorry, buddy. Let's get you inside.
Yeah. Okay, Dad.
Thanks, guys. Oh, and, if Claire asks, tell her everything is fine.
Sure. No problem.
Cool. See you around then.
Thanks, guys. See you later.
Yes, we will.
Daniel, did you forget everything about the rules already?
Sorry, Sean. Did you want me to let him fall? Really?
No, you did the right thing. But listen, we can't let anybody know. We have to keep a low profile out here.
He's like my age. I bet you would have done the same exact thing. Don't be mad.
I'm not mad, dude. It's over. Daniel, remember that we're hiding out, so no training and no showing off your power. From now on, you stick with me all the time, okay? Fuck. That kitten never listens. Okay. Time to get Daniel at the Erickson's. Claire? Steven? Anybody home?
Well, looks like I'm home alone. Well, I guess they won't be back for at least 2 hours. Maybe I could use Steven's laptop. It's been ages since I've had news from the real world. Okay, let's get this brat back home now. Why does Daniel never listen? Maybe I'm too soft with him.
Daniel, what's going on here?
Sean, wait, don't freak out. I can't explain.
Let me tell him. Sean, I know it sounds crazy, but I have a superpower. You saw me yesterday. I know you did. I was flying. I can move things. Objects. With my mind.
Oh. Superpower. Really?
Yes.
Well, that's pretty cool, Chris. So, you're like a superhero?
I'm Captain Spirit. I can bend any matter to my will. But that's my secret identity, so you can't tell anybody.
Oh, I can keep a secret, Captain Spirit.
Now you're an official member of the Spirit Squad. If you betray us, I'll disintegrate you. Nah, just kidding. Oh yeah, we need a... team signal.
Totally! I'm gonna be Super Wolf. What's your super name, Sean?
I don't know. Something cool like El Diablo Loco.
Sounds like a supervillain's name. But okay.
Okay, guys, I think we're ready to roll. Excuse me. Who are you?
I'm Sean.
Sorry, man. You're here for Daniel. Hey, let's make it official. I'm Charles Erickson.
Nice to meet you.
Hope you know that Daniel and Chris are a dangerous team. We better watch out, or they're gonna take over the world.
Yeah, they share a lot of things. As thick as thieves.
Can we go get the Christmas tree now? We're both ready to fly.
Yes, yes, yes. The team has been waiting too long. Hey, you should come along too. There's nothing going on over here.
Yes! Can't wait to see all the decorations. And Sean, we could buy Christmas presents for Grandma and Grandpa.
Well, they'll worry if we leave the house. And remember, you still have to get better, Daniel.
Sean, come on. You know I haven't done anything fun since I got sick. It's the first time I've been out for days.
We won't be gone for long. The market's only a few miles away. Anyway, they'll be at the service for at least another hour.
Yeah, Sean, I can show Daniel around. You can come with us. Please say yes.
Please, please, please.
Okay, you win. Not a fair fight. So let's go.
Yes!
Yeah!
See? Dangerous. Okay, team, give me a time out to clean up the back seat. I'll honk when I'm done.
Ooh, can I use the bathroom?
Of course. Oh, you'll see my comic books. I'm glad you're coming, too. Hey, you want to see my toys?
Oh, score! The new hot dog man?
Since you're a new member of the team, you have to know everybody. These are Captain Spirit's friends and his enemies.
Dude, that's pretty cool.
Can you guess who are the good guys and the villains?
Let's see.
Interesting. Look closely. The bad guys, the good guys. Not that easy, right? Careful. It may be tricky. Look closely. You sure? Interesting. Careful. It may be tricky. The bad guys, the good guys. Not that easy, right? Okay. Look closely. Careful. It may be tricky. The bad guys, the good guys. Not that easy, right? Careful. It may be tricky.
Okay. How did I do?
You're not a very good observer. Okay, let me introduce them to you. This is Team Spirit, the good guys. There's the Forest Warrior, Power Bear, Marty Rex, and Sky Pirate.
So, who are the bad guys?
That's Noctarius and the Shark Stinger. There's also Snowmancer, but he's out in the garden. But they're all working for Mantroid, who's the real supervillain.
So, where is he?
Hiding out on his evil planet, waiting for me. But Captain Spirit and Super Wolf will make sure he doesn't hurt anyone.
Yeah. Strength in numbers. Sounds like Mantroid is in trouble.
Just wait until he sees what Captain Spirit can do now.
Yeah, about that. Does your dad know about any of this? Did he see something yesterday?
No, he didn't see anything, and the power didn't work yesterday, after I fell. Must have been too tired.
Okay, good. He could be pretty disturbed if he knew.
I'm definitely not telling Dad. I don't want to freak him out. He's worried about other stuff anyway.
Well, your dad is cool. He totally hooked you up with that treehouse.
Yeah, he let Steven build it for me. It's my flying fortress.
I bet. There's no stopping him from building things.
Well, Captain Spirit had to help him, of course.
Obviously. All hail Captain Spirit, the first and only Carpenter Vigilante.
Ah, too cold.
Sorry, the water eater is still broken.
There's the signal. Come on, Daniel.
Hey! Pro tip, don't go in there.
Yeah.
Okay, squad, let's roll. You need my jacket? I don't want you catching another cold.
No, I'm good. Thanks.
And don't be waving your arms around when I'm driving, okay?
Yeah. Remember, Daniel, don't mess around.
All right. Jeez.
Thank you.
Okay, buddy. You ready?
Yeah. Hey!
You guys go ahead and we'll come back to meet you, okay? Brothers meeting.
Sure.
But...
Don't get lost.
Dude, what the fuck are you doing? I can't believe it. How many times do we have to keep going over the rules?
Don't show the power. I know. But Chris thinks he can do all this cool stuff. I wish he could. He reminds me of Noah. I just miss having friends, Sean.
Listen, I understand, but we have to be extra careful out here. You can't let people see you. You know the rules.
Yes, I know the rules. But I'm careful. I only do things when it's me and Chris. Nobody sees us.
Yeah, nobody but me. What if it was Chris's dad? Or grandma? Or a cop? Or...
Okay. I get it. But I'm careful.
That's not enough. You have to be extra, extra careful.
All right. I swear I will.
Deal. I'm counting on you and Anno.
Can I go see Chris now?
Yeah, let's go. But don't forget what I said.
Wow. So many trees. Ugh. They look like giant cocoons. Creepy. You coming, Sean?
Don't worry. I'll be around. Dad pushed every year to get a plastic tree. But we never surrendered. Behold, the giant condom machine.
We have to pick the one we like. Can Daniel help, Dad?
Jeez. Daniel Snowman wasn't that creepy after all.
Okay, just pick the one you like and come get me.
I've never been on such a dangerous mission.
Yeah, these wild trees are just waiting to eat us.
We'll have to tame the one we want.
Dear Santa, we've been good kids this year. Please explain this hot mess.
Tell me if you need anything, okay?
Sure.
Is that a yo-yo? Daniel had one back home. Bet he'd love this. This guy is looking over here. Better not try anything yet. This guy is looking over here. Better not try anything yet. Claire and Steven definitely have a kink for Christmas. Pet that like these. Hi, everybody. We're taking a year off to run away from cops. Daniel has got telekinesis now. Hope you're doing well.
We only sell handmade local products. Come take a look.
Reminds me of that lovely rocket Daniel made for me once.
You won't find better deals in Beaver Creek.
It's weird to have all this food around after a month of ravioli diet.
Quiet morning.
I know it sucks, but Daniel deserves it too. Right?
Quiet morning.
It's not much, but she probably needs it more than me right now. Whoa. The guy who painted that, he must have been seriously high.
Found what you were looking for, city boy?
Yeah. Something for my little brother.
You bought your brother something out here. Damn. Poor kid. Sorry. I'm just a grumpy old gal. Me and my friends have been crashing here for the week. Nobody gives a shit about us. Yeah, I can tell you're not from around here.
No, no way. Just here for the holidays.
Ah. You got family?
My grandparents.
Gotta love the grandparents.
What about you and your friends? Road trip?
Not really. We kinda hop from place to place, hunting for little jobs.
Must be a long ride.
That's okay. We hop on trains. Gives us time to rest.
Man, that sounds wicked.
You have no idea. It's free and so fucking fun. Well, unless you get caught or fall, but we've been lucky so far. That's the best. Nobody tells us what to do. No corporation owns us.
And you get to see so many cool places.
Exactly. Next stop is Humboldt County, California.
Stoner break.
Not even close. We actually got work over there.
Sean, what are you doing? We've hit the tree with Chris. It's all crooked like an old witch. Oh, hi. Who are you? Ooh, your hair looks so cool. Is it a wig?
Well, what do you think?
I don't know, but it's really cool. I'm Daniel. What's your name?
Hi, Daniel. I'm Cassidy. I dig your superhero outfit.
I'm on a secret mission with my friend. It's very dangerous.
I can tell. I hope you get your mission accomplished. And what's your name?
Oh, Sean. I thought I told you.
No, you did.
Sorry, you went through some shit with the guys. How much you make? You ready? Hello, pups.
Ooh, is that your doggy? So cool.
Yeah, he's been through a lot. Like most of us. So we adopted him. And he stinks. Yeah, you stink and you like it, huh?
Well, he's not the only one.
Have you checked your hair? I think it just twitched. You should keep your distance, dude.
She looks really cool, I think.
See? He knows I'm clean. You're the nasty one.
Yeah, you always go for those suburban boys.
Are you kidding? You want to talk about your scoreboard, hotshot?
Hey, no worries.
Come on, let's bail.
It was nice meeting you, Sean and Daniel.
Stay out of trouble,
goodbye.
Kids.
Bye.
Hope we see you on the rails someday.
Yeah. See you around.
Your doggy was so cute. I miss Mushroom.
I miss her too.
Hey, excuse me. Dogs have to be on a leash around here. Too many strays.
Sorry, dude. We don't do leashes.
Well, the city does. An unleashed dog is liable to a fine. so...
You're gonna fine our dog? Well, that's not very nice.
Loitering is illegal, too. And you don't live here, right? Right?
Calm down, sweetie. We're allowed to visit the Christmas market. Our dog's not gonna eat you. Look at him.
You better watch your mouth. You punks are always causing trouble. This is a nice town, okay?
Jeez. Someone needs to get laid.
He's out of pills.
That's it. I'm calling the cops.
Oh, God. He's gonna call the cops on us, Finn.
Chill out. We're leaving this shithole anyway. You guys don't even have a Santa, for Christ's sake.
Merry Christmas.
Fucking parasites.
Why did they fight? I don't get why he yelled like that. We should kick his ass, Sean.
See the snow on that booth?
Yeah. What about it?
Maybe this guy needs a shower. You know? To cool him down.
You're right. Hold on.
Careful. Careful.
This will teach him.
Nice.
Come on.
They're pretty. So cool. How do I look, Sean?
Ridiculous.
Aw, you're jealous because I'm cute. You're a loss.
Whoa. The guy who painted that, he must have been seriously high.
I miss my old toys.
Hey, you guys ready to go?
Yeah.
All done.
Cool. Hop in. Are you having too much fun back there?
Yeah.
That's what I thought. Looks like Daniel found a new brother.
No kidding. He dumped me like a rock.
I'm glad you two came along. It's great that Chris found a new friend out here. It looks like you did too. What's her name?
Cassidy? Cassidy.
Cute name. Do you like her?
She was cool.
You're too quick!
Anyway,
got ya!
It's good for me to get out, too. We've had a rough time over the past couple of years. My wife, Emily, she died 2 years ago. Obviously, it was tough on Chris.
Shit. I'm sorry, man.
Thanks. It's been a struggle, especially trying to be a good dad.
You're doing your best. Chris is awesome. And he's got a wonderful imagination.
Well, thanks for saying that. Chris does have talent. He's a storyteller.
I see that. Just like Daniel.
When I look at you and Daniel, how close you two are, I realize I'm far from being up to the task. Chris deserves a real family. Anyway, I shouldn't have brought this up. Okay? Forget it.
No worries. Didn't mean to make you feel bad.
We all have our ups and downs, right? That's how life works. Your grandparents sure did have their share of downs, too. But they're always there for us. For Chris. They seem like good people.
They're so nice, but yeah. They have their problems, too.
Sorry for bringing that up.
It's okay. I hope they don't stress out because we haven't come back.
Yeah, we should get you two home. Don't keep them waiting.
Yeah.
Hey, buddy. Want to set up that Christmas tree?
Yeah!
Well, I'll get there before you with my dadmobile.
No way you can beat Captain Spirit.
See you later, Super Wolf.
Hello? Hello? Claire? Steven?
Looks like Grandma and Grandpa haven't come back from church yet.
Well, at least they won't yell at us for going out.
That was so cool to spend time with Chris at the market. Did you know Chris's mom was an artist?
I didn't. How so?
She drew comics. You should see her drawings. They're so cool. just like yours.
Thanks, dude.
Hey.
What? What is it?
Sean, I want to go check on the room. Upstairs. I know it's Mom's. Please.
Daniel, you heard Claire. They will freak out if they know we went inside.
We won't tell them. We'll be in total stealth mode. They won't know anything if we make it quick. It's just... I really want to know what's inside. What kind of stuff she had. Chris has tons of things that belong to his mom. And I have nothing. Come on, Sean. You don't even have to come with me. If you don't want to.
Fuck it. I'll come with you. So you don't make a mess and get us caught. We'll find a way to open it.
Or I could just blow this stupid door up with my power. That looks super easy.
Yeah, I could do that with a hammer. But let's try and find the key instead, all right?
I'm just gonna clean up real quick.
Okay, Steven. Where do you hide this key?
Stay here in case they come back.
I don't really see Steven listening to old school pop rock music. We clearly don't share politics, but at least Steven doesn't. Yeah, not much to see in here. It would be cool to ask Steven about his firefighting career. He must have had tons of things to tell. Karen's smile on this picture kind of reminds me of Daniel's. That would have been really useful when we lived in the woods. Small town hero starter pack. Shit. Wish I had the chance to find my thing too.
Sean, hurry up! They might come back.
Shit. These are Christmas presents? Let's not tell Daniel, or he'd freak. Clothes, old stuff, but definitely no hidden key. Locked drawer. Maybe the key to Karen's room is inside. Yeah, no. No way I'm searching Claire's underwear.
Sean, I saw Grandma go into the room yesterday. It looked like she left something there, but...
Come on, little key. Don't be shy. Definitely not the one. Way too small. But let's see what it opens. Whoa. I'm just looking for a key. Not the crown jewels. Ew. Are these milk teeth? I'm not sure if it's gross or cute. But still, no key here. Sharp objects. Bit like Claire. Come on, little key. Don't be shy.
didn't know Claire had sleep troubles. I guess I wonder what would have been different if Dad had taken us to church. How much more Irish can you be?
Okay, Daniel. Think hard.
Gotta find a way to open that door, or Daniel's gonna keep ranting about it. Yep, it's empty. Come on, where is this cardigan? No way she wore it to church. Gotta find a way to open that door, or Daniel's gonna keep ranting about it. Karen hated collecting trinkets. She used to say they were just useless dust traps. Love the outfits, guys. Who knew this sweet little muffin would turn into such a brat? Still super cute, though.
Come on, Sean. You can't find the key. I can still use my power.
Daniel, you really think you could open this door without doing too much damage?
Yes, I know I can't.
We have to get into that room before they come back. We have to get into that room before they come back. Come on, little Kiki. Don't be shy. Okay, Steven. Where do you hide this key?
Yeah, not much to see in here. Damn, too high for me. Yes. I found one key, so it better fit.
Just try it. Wow. There's not that much left. Where do you think they put the rest of her stuff?
It's her teenage room. I'm sure she sorted through. It's like she almost never used those. It's her teenage room. I'm sure she sorted through her things before leaving for Seattle. The rest, I think I remember that one. Karen showed it to me once. Ulysses? Hey, Daniel, check this out. His name is Ulysses.
Like, the hero?
I guess.
So,
they looked happy.
So cool.
These pictures are so random. Is that an amethyst? She was into New Age bullshit. Yeah. You finally left forever. Coward. Man. That pen pal sure loved listening to her own voice. Guess the no phone rule wasn't such a thing back then.
Hi, Ulysses.
Well, figures Karen was already looking for an exit. Well, Karen was already looking for an exit.
So, you were a friend of my mommy's?
Hope you enjoyed your trips. So you didn't bail on us for nothing.
I hope she took good care of you.
Read a lot of these in the 10th grade. Yawn. This playlist is boring as hell.
Did she take you with her when she went on trips? I wonder my mom loved it so much.
Karen liked to take pictures of strangers when we walked down the streets. Never been a big fan of hiking.
You're not that fluffy anymore.
But here I was. I think I saw a moon eclipse once. Before Daniel was born. Karen was... I miss my skateboard. And going to the park. With Lila. I think it's not plugged. They want to forget anything related to Karen. I can relate. I don't recognize any of these games. These pictures are so random. Read a lot of these in the 10th grade. Yawn. Hope you enjoyed your trips. So you didn't bail on us for nothing. What is wrong with this? Oh, hiding spot. Smart. So, Karen was already serious about running away. Why did you wait that long? This playlist is boring as hell.